You guys know about physics and all that stuff because you're in school, you're learning about that. The smaller those things are, the harder they are to roll up. So I went to Walmart and I got a pack of the little ones. And I'm going to show you guys how I can turn that thing into a little bitty cigar. You guys want to see that today?
Yeah!
All right. And then, here we go. This is the one that I hate the worst. This is a carriage pole. This is what is holding my pole barn together. Lois says that the sheer strength on this is 2,000 pounds. And with my bare hands today, I'm going to snap it in two. You guys want to see that?
Yeah!
No, I'm going to keep it one time because that hurts. And then we got, well, you guys probably don't know what these things are anymore, do you? I figured with the telephones and all that internet stuff, you wouldn't know what they are anymore. This is the Oakland Northeast. This thing is absolutely disgusting. The bigger they are, the harder they are to do. So, I'm going to give this one to Ralph today.
Thanks, brother.
You're welcome. See, he's a young guy. I actually taught him how to, before you guys were born, I taught him how to rip a phone book. How about that? And then, somebody parked in your principal's parking spot, so I pulled this off the back of their car. I'm just kidding. If you look at this, I couldn't believe when I pulled this out. This is a 1979 license plate. Do you know I was in high school?
What?
That's how old it is, yeah. But what they always do with these things is the big strong guys and strong man competition, I used to beat them, they take them in their hands and they rip them apart. Ralph, you'd like to say that I am the what of the team?
The mouth.
Ah, they usually say I'm the Jack Russell Terrier because I run around running my mouth all the time.
Oh, I thought it was going to be a jump high. Like Jack
Russell's
like,
not anymore. That was probably about 30 years ago. For you guys, I'm going to fight this in half. You guys want to see that one again? Right. And then, we have half-inch hot-rolled steel, 5-foot section. And today, we're going to do this on your teeth.
Sure.
I bought my coffee today from Tim Hortons. It's the last time I do that. It's my coffee restriction for the rest of the time.
Ah,
you want to do that in your teeth?
Sure.
Oh!
Why not?
He's going to put this in his teeth, and then he's going to wrap it around 2.5 times.
My wife will be really happy because I just had $2,000 worth of dental procedures on. And I'm going to put this in my brand new fixed up teeth. Isn't that awesome?
I like it. So what? Well, so we get the party started. Keep that microphone. Let's get it started here.
Come on, let's get it started in here. Let's go, baby. Come on. Premium license plate being ripped in half by Dan the Man Ford. Yep, those arms are 52 years old too. Come on, Dan. Let's go. Help me. You got any love for it? Come on. Let's get inside of here. Come on, Dan. Come on, baby. That's unbelievable. Wow. Come on. Easy, big fella. Easy. Whoa. It's starting to rip. We need your help. Audience, put in the paper. Come on. Rip through it like a sheet of paper. Let's give it up for Dan the Man Ford. There you go, baby. So, Maestro, what do you want next? Sure. I'll get the steel bar out of the way.
Anybody gonna be a dentist? Because I think I need one.
I got the steel bar out of the way.
All right, I'm gonna get here to time out in a minute. So, no, Ralph, the idea is for you to come up here in front of them and twist this steel bar around.
You said
get
out of the way, huh?
Yes, all right. Alright, you guys want to see this? We used to do this. While he's rolling it up, we used to do this in World Songman competition, and the guys just put it on top of their head, and the reason they stopped doing it is because guys were ripping their bicep doing it.
Stop. I'm worried about my teeth. I'm worried about my bicep.
Yeah.
Just give me.
Alright, Wreck-It Ralph, are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Alright, come on, put your hands together for Wreck-It Ralph. Come on, help me. Here we go. Oh, he needs our help. Yeah, it's 2-1-1. 2-1-1. Come on, man. Oh. Oh, come on, help me out. Oh, my goodness. Here it goes. Oh, this is awful. That is awful. He's halfway there. Here it goes. Help him out. There's one full pass. He's still going. Work it. Work it. Come on, Ralph. Wow. That's kind of hurt. Go over the bicep now. Come on, Ralph. Wow. Look at this. Here we go. He's actually bringing it back around. Now, up it comes on the chest. Yay.
Cross it over.
He's actually, this is the hardest part of crossing it over. And he's making it look easy. Holy cow. Nice job, bro. There you go. You know, before I get into a little bit more of this stuff and we get one more going, I want to bring Ralph up here. I've known him for a long time, and his story is really quite amazing. As a kid, he spent a majority of his time in the hospital because of a pretty debilitating disease that a lot of you guys actually have. And through sheer willpower, working out, and doing everything he could to change himself, he became the amazing trainer that you see up in front now. That those guys that can lift up the Atlas stones and throw them on stuff, he's unbelievably strong. I always call it monkey strength. He's just unreal. So, Ralph, you want to tell me your story? All right, put your hands together for Ralph.
How y'all doing?
Good.
How are you all doing? Awesome. Actually, where I come from in southeastern Ohio, it's called Y apostrophe ALL. Y'all. I think that's how it is. I hope the American teachers in here do not get on me. You know, I like to have some fun. I'm actually a tutor at a school down there beside me. And the reason that I tutor, the reason that I travel the country, and the reason that I train is so that I can inspire and help. So that I can motivate and figure out what's inside of each and every one of you guys that makes you special, that makes you unique. You see, I have one particular young man, he's in the eighth grade right now, who has autism. And when he came to our school, he was filled with anger, frustration, some hate. But it took some patience. Took some time, took some understanding, and it takes some realization that he wasn't like everybody else. You know what? That's the same with each and every one of you guys. The reason it's difficult to be an administrator, the reason it's difficult to be a teacher a lot of times, is because you are not like you. You are not like that person back there, and none of you guys are the same. So we have to figure out what makes you tick, what you enjoy, and how to get you guys to be successful. And if you guys will become a team, look at the person to your left, look at the person to your right, and save the world the same team. Right. Thank you. So the young man that I tutor with, listen to me please, eyes up here. The reason that I have been successful with a young man with autism is because I got him to believe and he's told me this before, that his disability is actually a super ability. You see, he's able to see things in a unique way that others around him cannot see. When he's sitting in class a lot of times, even though some students aren't being disruptive, he is disrupted by the simple fact of different noises that we don't even notice. And we've been able to be successful. We only go up through eighth grade, and we're getting ready to send him home. You know, if I didn't take the time to find out what was special about him, he might not be successful now. So that's the reason, one of the reasons it's difficult to be a teacher and an administrator, is because we've got to figure out what makes each and every one of you guys special. And then I also am a fitness trainer, and right now I'm working with a boy who's cerebral palsy. His goal was to walk across state for graduation. He's had several different trainers, he's had different therapists, and they come to me and they said, can you do this? And when I got there, he couldn't stand up straight because of his posture, which means he had trouble standing up again. He had trouble sitting straight even. But once again, I tapped into that. What makes him unique, where his weaknesses are, we worked on his weaknesses, we made him a strength, and he was able to walk across stage to graduation. See, each and every one of you guys have something to offer to this home team right here. Hope you guys will go out and find out what that is. Each and every one of you guys are special. Dan, do we have anything else for?
Yeah, we got lots of stuff.
Let's get this party started. Before I do anything, if you guys wouldn't mind going to my YouTube channel, check it out. The Real Wreck-It Ralph is my YouTube channel. I put things on there about training. I put things on there about motivation. And I hope that I can affect many people. Yeah. Real Wreck-It Ralph. Go, Dave. You got a phone book for me? So you're going to make me talk, and then you're going to, oh my goodness. What is this, Rocky Show?